morning everyone, my name is Isha. I am from Tribri department, working as assistant professor in St. Martin Engineering College. Today I am going to discuss about the in machines, the DC motor we are discussing. Okay, in machines, the DC motor we are discussing. First we will see about the DC motor. Okay, first we will see about the DC motor. So we will see the principle. Okay, the principle of the DC motor is a current carrying conductor was placed in the magnetic field. Is nothing but magnetic field, it produces some force. Okay, it produces some force. So in this principle, okay, the principle, so we will see the construction of the DC motor. We will see the construction of the DC motor. Okay, we will see the construction of the DC motor. Construction of the DC motor. It has a yoke. Okay, the first one, it has a yoke. Okay, it has a yoke. And towards the yoke, it has a field windings. Okay, towards the yoke, it is nothing but pole core. Okay, it is nothing but pole core. Pole core having the pole shoe. Okay, the pole core having the pole shoe. Okay, four poles we are taking. Pole core having the pole shoe. Okay, pole core having the pole shoe. This is a pole shoe. The fourth pole we are taking towards the DC motor. Okay, pole shoe. Okay, it was this pole shoe and having the field windings. Towards the pole shoe having the field windings. Okay, field windings. Okay, field windings. Four pole we attach the four field windings. Okay, the next one, it have the armature. Now we are going to draw the cross section of the armature. Now we are going to draw the cross section of the armature. Okay, now we are going to draw the cross section of the armature. The armature having the slots. These are the slots. Armature having the slots. Okay, the armature having the slots. In the slots, the armature winding will be there. It is nothing but conductors will be there. Okay, here inside the armature, we have the commutator. Okay, inside the armature, we have the commutator. Okay, we have the commutator segments. Okay, these are the commutator segments. Towards the commutator segments, the pressures will be there. The pressures will be there, and inside the commutator the shaft will be there. Okay, inside the commutator shaft will be there. So we will see now the parts. Okay, now we will see the parts of the DC motor. It is nothing but pole shoe. Okay, pole shoe. Okay, pole shoe. It is nothing but pole core. Okay, pole core. Okay, it is nothing but pole core. And here it is nothing but field winding. Okay, it is nothing but field winding. Okay, it is nothing but field winding. It is nothing but armature. Okay, armature. Okay, it is nothing but armature. Okay, here it is nothing but armature slots. Okay, here it is nothing but armature slots. Okay, armature slots. In this armature slot, the armature conductor will be this. Armature windings will be this. Okay, it is in here. The one more thing, it is nothing but commutator segments. Okay, commutator. Okay, it is nothing but the commutator. And here it is nothing but the brushes. Okay, it is nothing but the brushes. Okay, here it is nothing but the brushes. So it is the internal connection of the windings. Field windings is the internal connection of the field windings. Okay, this is the internal connection of the field windings. So I am giving the supply. Okay, I am giving the DC supply to this. I am giving the DC supply to this field winding. Okay, DC supply to this field winding. And it is nothing but the yoke. Okay, it is nothing but the yoke. This is a yoke, is a very important part of the DC motor. Okay, it is a house of the magnetic flux. It is a house of the magnetic flux. So I am giving the DC supply to the field winding. So it is nothing but here the flux is generating. Here the flux is generating towards the one field winding to the another field winding. So here the magnetic field, okay, the magnetic flux was flowing with the yoke from one field winding to the another field winding. So the flux is generating from one pole to another pole. So the flux was flowing in the yoke from one field winding to another field winding. Here also the flux was flowing from one field winding to another field winding. So here, what is the purpose of the pole core? What is the purpose of the pole core? The pole core was attached to the pole. It was attached to the yoke. Okay, it was attached to the yoke and pole shoe. Okay, the pole core gives the place for the field winding. Here the pole shoe. This is a pole shoe. Pole shoe. Here the pole shoe. It will produce the uniform magnetic field. Okay, it will produce the uniform magnetic field. Here the pole core. Okay, here the field windings. Here the field windings material is copper. Okay, the field winding material is copper. Okay, material is copper. And yoke material is silicon. It is nothing but cast iron. Okay, it is nothing but cast iron. Okay, here also the pole shoe material is cast iron. Okay, pole shoe material is cast iron. Okay, here what is the purpose of the pole shoe? It distributes the uniform magnetic flux. Okay, it distributes the uniform magnetic flux across the armature. Okay, it distributes the uniform magnetic flux across the armature. This is the distributed uniform magnetic flux. This is the distributed uniform magnetic flux. Okay, the magnetic flux was entering into the armature. The armature consists of the slots. Okay, the armature consists of the armature conductors. Here, a current carrying conductor. Okay, a current carrying conductor was placed in the magnetic field. It is nothing but uniform magnetic field. It produced some force. Okay, it produced some force. That force, it is nothing but. Okay, it experienced some force. That force, it is nothing but B L I sin theta. It is nothing but the flux density. Okay, the flux density. Flux density is nothing but length of the conductor, length of the conductor, and I is nothing but current flowing in the conductor, and current flowing in the conductor, and sin theta is nothing but the length of the conductor, the angle of the conductors, angle between the conductors. Okay, angle between the conductors. Okay, angle between the conductors. Here it is nothing but a current carrying conductor was placed in a uniform magnetic field. It experienced some force. That force, it is nothing but F equals to P L and sin theta. P is nothing but flux density. It is nothing but the length of the conductor. It is nothing but current. Current in the current flow in the conductors. And sin theta is nothing but angle between the conductors. This is about the force. Okay, this is about the force. So current carrying conductor was placed in magnetic field, experienced some force. This armature, this armature conductor cuts the flux, uniform magnetic flux. Okay, it produces the induced EMF. Okay, it produces the induced EMF in the commutator. It produces the induced EMF in the commutator, is nothing but voltage. This voltage was taken by the pressures. Okay, this voltage was taken by the pressure. From the pressures, it's given to the load. Okay, from the pressures, it's given to the load. Okay, these are all the construction of the DC motor. So we discussed till now the different parts of the DC motor, their functions also, and their material also. Okay, their material also. And here we are going to, and we discussed the principle of the DC motor. Resulting by current carrying conductor was placed in the magnetic field. It experienced some force. Okay, it experienced some force. The force is nothing but this one. And again, we'll see how the single conductor. Okay, we'll take the single conductor. How it was rotating to that rotation. How the force was getting and how the torque was getting. We'll see now. Okay, by taking the single conductor. Okay, by taking the single conductor, we'll see now. So we'll see now. Going to draw the two poles. Okay, two poles in single conductor, and north pole and south pole. This is the flux. This is a flux flowing from north to south. This is a flux flowing from north to south, and this is a single conductor. Okay, I'm taking a single conductor to see how with the single conductor. Here the pressures will be constant. Okay, here the pressures will be constant. See here, here the flux, here the flux, it was cutting. When it was perpendicular to the flux, when it was delta, the single conductor was perpendicular to the flux, here the no production of torque and no cutting of flux will be there. Okay, here the same diagram, when it was replaced with the same diagram, when it was rotating, okay, another direction, and here the slip rings also will rotate with respect to the single conductor. Here also the same thing, the flux, okay, the flux will flow from north to south, okay, the flux will flow from north to south, and again we are going to see how the conductor was rotating. How next, the next diagram we are saying that how the conductor was rotating with respect to the slip rings we are going to see. Okay, with respect to the slip rings we are going to see. So this is C and this is G and this is A and this is B. Okay, here C2, C1. Here the slip rings having the pressures. Okay, the slip rings. Okay, the slip rings having the pressures. Pressures. Okay, towards these pressures are giving the supply voltage. Okay, see here now. See the difference of the circuit now. Okay, see the difference of the circuit. See the conductor was rotating. Okay, see the conductor was rotating with the help of the slip rings. Here also see. Here CD will comes towards the north pole and AB will comes towards the south pole. See this, C was rotating. When the magnetic flux was perpendicular to the perpendicular of the single conductor, no production of torque and no flux will be produced, no induced EMF will be produced. See the difference. See here, C and D was come towards the north and A and B was comes towards the south. So this is a single conductor which was taken between the two poles. I was shown the how it was rotating with the slip rings. Okay, with the slip rings. So this is a construction of the DC motor and working principle of the DC motor and how it was rotating. We will see the back EMF. It is nothing but a current, okay, a current carrying conductor was placed in the uniform magnetic field. It produces